Ciao friends! In this video, I want to show you how to use the USERELATIONSHIP function in DAX. And to do that, I'm gonna show you a calculation. You see that I have year and sales amount. I want to compute a new measure, which is the delivered amount. Now, in my data model, I have two date columns in my sales table. So, let's take a look at it. We have the order date and we also have the delivery date. The model contains a date table that is linked to the order date table. You see that this relationship is between the date and the order date. This means that a filter on date will go to sales and filter the order date. So when I compute sales amount, I compute the amount that was sold in a given period. What I want to do is create a relationship between delivery date and date and use that relationship when I want to compute the delivery amount. I can do that. I can start a relationship between delivery date and date, but you see that the relationship is kept disabled between any two tables that can be a single path in a tabular model. So I cannot have two relationships active at the same time between the two tables. How is DAX supposed to move a filter from date to sales if there are two ways of moving that filter? That's why you cannot have only one active. But having one active in the model does not mean you cannot activate the inactive path on demand. And that's exactly what USERELATIONSHIP is for. What I can do if I want to compute the delivery amount is create a new measure, which I will call delivered amount. Let's call delivery amount. I need to use USERELATIONSHIP. USERELATIONSHIP is one of the many calculate modifiers. That's why I need to start my measure with calculate. Then I compute sales amount. Sales amount by default will compute the amount of sales using the default relationship. But I can use USERELATIONSHIP to disable the old one and enable the new one. So I need to use USERELATIONSHIP between sales delivery date and date. USERELATIONSHIP basically says, for the duration of this calculate and this calculate only, use this relationship disabling the other one. As soon as calculate finishes, the other relationship, the default one, will become active again. Now that I have my delivery amount, I only need to format it as a decimal number, and then I take it, I drop it in my report, and I have side by side the order amount and the delivered amount. Of course, the two might be the same if exactly the same number of orders have been ordered and delivered in a month, or they might be different because an order was received near the end of the month and delivered later. USERELATIONSHIP is extremely useful when you have multiple relationships. With that said, having multiple relationships between dates, between tables, is an advanced feature, so use it with care, but it's extremely powerful. Enjoy DAX!